Now we see the sensory system first. So sensory systems. So what are the features of sensory system? We will see, or we have. The first thing about the sensory system is it has three basic main parts. Okay. So what are the three parts? Receptors. Okay. Pathways. And cortical centers. Okay. So any sensory system you people read is having what three part? Receptors, pathways and cortical centers. Okay. So I have to teach all properly. Okay. Pathways I can just take relaxation. Why? Because they are taught in anatomy very well. So I can just discuss the function, not the exact anatomy. Okay. So let's start with the part receptors. What they do? Convert any stimulus, they convert any stimulus into electrical impulses. Okay, into GP, then AP. Okay, so I'll discuss this later. What is GP or RP? Don't worry, I'll discuss it. So one line, they convert any stimulus, touch, pressure, vibration, light, sound, anything, pressure, into GP or RP, then APs. APs are action potential. Pathways. What the pathways do? They will conduct these APs to cortical centers. To cortical centers. What is the function of pathway? Just one. Conduct the information, the impulses from the receptors to the cortical center, and the whole game occur in the cortical center. So what is the game there? First is it causes processing of info by networks, you can say neural networks. So what will process the information? The neural networks will process. What is processing? You know a microprocessor, a chip, AMD, Snapdragon, the Intel, Intel i7, Pentium, they are all processors. What does a processor do? I will tell you. See this. Can you see this thing? Okay. What is this thing? It is a, yes, it is a equation showing the mathematical logic of addition between two positive integers which are added and shown into the final process output as number 4. So what is 2? This inputs. What is plus? It is the operation. And what is 4? Is the final output. So what is the processor? This plus this. So that is why conversion of input to output is what a processor does. Your brains are processors. So if you remember, I told you when I was discussing the topic of what EPSP, IPSP brain, what your brains are nothing but adding machines. They add the EPSPs and IPSPs, and what is created by addition of EPSP, IPSP? The final output in the form of motor responses. So that is why your brain creates circuits. Like there are circuits in a chip which can be programmed to give the output. Same way your brain can be programmed from the beginning. When you are born, your brain has very little networks, but as you grow, because of synaptic connection, there is formation of multiple patterns and the networks, and these networks will take the input and give the output. Okay. Like example, once you are listening to a language, let us say you learn your mother tongue, how? Very simple. As you listen to the word, it causes circuits, patterns, pathways form in your auditory cortex. So as a result, what happens? You start to speak the same word, that is the output, and as they match, you say the same word and get the response. Let us say I say this pani in my native tongue, pani. Okay, but someone might be saying the word thani, thani, or jal, or maybe water. What happens? It causes a formation of a feedback system. So when you say this word, what happens? You get the water, and now this word become a learned information. Is it clear? So when you want the water, you're thirsty, you will speak out what output? The word water or pani, you get the water. Is it clear? So that's why what is causing the processing? The circuits in the brain are causing, and how you create the circuits by synapses. So let me explain this properly. So one thing is clear. So what is processing means? Conversion of input to the final output via the networks. And how networks are formed? By connection between neurons. Okay. So how they are formed? Due to connections between neurons, called as synapses. Fine. So called as the synapses. Number two, perception. So number two is perception. Okay. What is perception? Again, occurrent cortex. What is perception? Understanding of sensation. Again, it require processing. So require processing to understand the sensation. Okay. So let me give a idea. Okay. You will understand. Okay. I can give multiple. See, I make a circle. I say, what is this? You say circle. Then I put what? Two dots. You will say circle with two dots. The moment I put a curved line, you say sir, it's a face. Clear? You will say it's a face. So what happened? Just a curvature will convert this circle with two dots into a face. Yes or no? Clear? And what happens if I put things like this and this? You can now say it might be some person from some other place, might be some Chinese person. So what happens? As you keep doing changes, your brain will keep creating different patterns of what? Perceptions, and that is why you are able to recognize them. So let me give a very simple perspective of this. Okay. When you give a stimulus, you can feel, that is called a sensation. Okay. But when you understand what, when, where, how, who, it becomes perception. So this perception is not just sensation, it is understanding of sensation. Let us give example. A newborn baby can feel the pain but does not understand. So that is why he is crying when the pain is there. Now take example, a slightly older kid, let us say 4 or 5 year old. Okay. So now what happens when you take him for vaccination? He start to crying when he see the injection. Why? Because he is able to process the information that this needle will cause the same pain without actual pain bill there. Why? Because he can understand it will cause the pain, and the injection is there, he can tell you it is very severe pain, is burning, I do. So now he is able to understand. He is not just feeling the pain, he is understanding the cause of the pain, the type of the pain, the location of the pain. That is called as what? Perception. And an adult, let us say a medical student, when he has to go to vaccination, he will feel the same pain. The pain felt by the newborn baby, that school going child, 5 year old, and a what, medical student, are same, but their perceptions are different. Same sensation, pain, needle, but sensations are different. No, they are same. Understanding, perception is different. I hope it is clear. Or you show a ECG to a layman, an intern, maybe a medical student, and a cardiologist. They both look at the, your three look at the same piece of information, but they all have same sensation. Yes, they see the same, they see the same waves. Yes or no? But one person see and he find, oh, it look like the camel hump sound, might be some hypothermia, etc. Other see, I don't know what is this. So that's why when they look at this, they will see the same object, but their perceptions are different. Or in night time, there are people going and they see this black color object lying on the floor. So two people are going, they see this black object, they both have same perception, black object, it is this long, this wide, but one person will see this and run away, he say snake, 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 he run away. Other person say, oh, it is a rope, and pick it up. So same object is causing what perception? Two perception. In one, snake perception, other rope. So what is perception? Is the ability to understand the sensation. I hope it is clear. So understanding is called as perception. And last is the one which you want to know the most, that is memory. That is the whole thing people keep asking, because memory is asked in, you can say, exam multiple time, and most people do not understand the memory very well. So it is my work to, let us explain the memory. First is, how is memory formed? Okay. So first is, to explain the memory, let me give a very simple idea. Okay. What happens? Okay. So there is, first thing, where is stored? So So it's stored at synapses in neocortex. So which area? Neocortex. Okay, which lobe? Main yeah, mainly. Main is medial temporal lobe. So I'll explain each and everything, don't worry. So understand first. Okay, multiple question. Where is memory stored? First is synapses. So which part of neuron memory actually stored? Is not the axon, not the cell body, it is a synapse. Which area synapses? Spinal cord? No. Brainstem? No. Mainly neocortex. Which area? Mainly neocortex. And which lobe of the brain? Neocortex is yes, all, but which area is involved? Yes, actually all the lobes, but main is medial, because it contain the what? Limbic system, it contain the hippocampus, etc. So if they have to give the option, if they give synapses, axon, the answer is synapse. They will not give a question like synapse, neocortex, okay, because you also know is asking something which is highly illogical, okay. So exam, they will not give a question medial temporal lobe, neocortex, synapse, clear, because they all are three different structure, okay. So let me give a question, how they will ask? They will ask, okay. So first is, if they say where is the information stored, answer is synapses between the neocortex neurons, okay. So answer is synapses. If they say neocortex, if they say what thing? Neocortex. So what will happen in neocortex? The information is being stored up, okay, clear. And what is the main area? The main area is medial temporal lobe out of the all brain areas, okay. Now how is memory formed? So let's start. The point is, there's something called as Hab's rule. So you can now just finish all this. I'll discuss the receptor later. We are discussing now only and only the memory. So the topic now, only and only the memory is the topic. So let's say first Hab's rule. Hab, okay. So Habian memory formation is first thing we will start, okay, Hab's rule. So we're discussing what topic? Memory. Topic is memory in details now, okay. So what is Hab's rule, right? Hab's rule, okay. Hab said that neurons that fire together, they wire together. So what it said? Ki the neurons which are working together, they tend to fire together. I hope it's clear. So if neurons are working together, they are wiring. So now what is the meaning? I'll give example. Wire means what? Stimulated by same stimulus. Okay. Example, face or some word. So let's say I tell you some word, okay, let's say some word, or I give you, let's say I tell you a word, aurora borealis, okay. So I said this word or some other word, okay. So when I give this word to you, what happens? This word will activate some of the neurons in your auditory cortex, okay. So are these neurons activated? Yes. Now as they are activated multiple time, they will wire, means what? Increase synapses between the same neurons which were triggered, which were earlier stimulated. So are you getting the concept? So when you stimulate some neurons, let's say you see a face, your visual cortex neurons are activated in a very peculiar fashion. Let's say this is the pattern of the face in the brain. I'm just making a circuit, okay. So when these neurons A, B, C, D, E, F, let's say A, B, C, D, they are all neurons, okay, they all points are neurons and they are axons. So what happens? As these neurons are triggered by the stimulus, after some time, what happens? The information is gone. Why? Why is the information gone? The answer is simple, because the stimulus is not repeated. So they are not stimulated, so information gone and you forget the thing. But if you repeat the info multiple time, there is increase what formation? Increase connection form between the same neurons. So in the future, you don't have to give the entire stimulus, just a trigger is sufficient to reactivate all the info. Is it clear? So that is why what happens once you create the synapse, this pattern become very strong, very well connected in the cortex, and next time you don't need original stimulus, you can reactivate the same information, same response, same output without actual stimulus. Okay, so let me just explain it, then I will give an writing. If I ask you, can you recall your mother's face in your brain? Like I say, close your eye and try to visualize her face. So are you able to do this? That means you can reactivate her facial information in your brain without seeing at her face. Or will you do this? Oh, mother's face, take the phone, hai na, and then start searching mother's face folder. Okay, you open the file and see. So do you have to see her face? Call her, mother, I want to see your face. No, you can trigger her facial information memory without looking at her face. Why? The answer is simple. When you used to look at her face as a baby, what happened? The neurons which are triggered by her face, all direction angle, they create such a strong network pattern because of increased synapses that now you don't need to see her face. Just one trigger, one cue, mother face, is going to make them all fire up. Like example, if they all are connected, like these neurons are all connected, just one stimulus will make them all fire in the same manner, and I am able to recall the same information. So earlier I used to stimulate them all by giving same stimulus, but now I don't have to give the stimulus, because earlier stimulus used to make them all connected and fire in a particular pattern, and now because of synapses they are already connected in my brain, so I don't have to repeat the stimulus. So I think you are getting the idea. What is memory? Give a stimulus, you get a sensation. Remove the stimulus, no sensation. Example, see the diagram, can you see this diagram? And now you can't see. So what happens? Can you draw this diagram back? Try. You will make like this, something like this, sir, something like this, some will make, sir, something like this. But are you making the real diagram? No, the real diagram is like this. So what happened? This is just a approximation based on whatever information was left. You are trying to use that to make the what information return back to your mind. So that is what a weak attempt. But if you make this diagram multiple times, like let's say I write the word physio, so I don't have to do effort. Why? Because my brain store all P's like this, H's like this. Why? This is all stored in my brain. So these patterns of physio, P, H, Y, or this diagram are all stored in your brain. So are you getting the idea? So when you give a stimulus, there is a release of neurotransmitter in the neurons of your brain, auditory cortex, visual cortex, in a very peculiar sequence. Like this is no stimulus, and this is stimulus. So without stimulus, with stimulus. Okay. So question is, when I remove the stimulus, it goes back to the previous state, that is resting state, and I cannot recall what the stimulus was because the stimulus is gone. But if you can somehow create the same pattern between the neurons, what happens? The next time you don't have to give the stimulus, you can recall the information based on the pattern already present in your cortex. Is it clear now? So one, two example, let's say I give you a word to see how much you are able to recall. I see the word Kilimanjaro. So what comes in your brain? What neurons are firing? Almost few, sir, maybe some mountain, something. But if I say the word tuberculosis, TB, now your brain is firing, one neuron trigger other than the other, and your brain is flashing with electrical activity. Why? Because the brain has heard the word TB so many times. Now you see, sir, RNTCP, sir, Nikshay program, sir, it is what? HRZDS, sir, there are three categories, sir, sputum positive, sir, lung, sir, miliary, sir, then HRZDS, okay, then we have what? LJ medium, rough tough buff colonies, also what? Malachite green is given, sir, something like what? It's a LJ medium. So all are coming in your brain, acid fast bacillus, okay. Why? Because we have learned so many times all this information that they have created a very strong pattern with this also, with that also, with that, and now just one stimulus of what? TB can make all of the circuit fire up, and you are able to recall this. So the secret of memory formation, connecting the neuron in the same manner they were connected when you were giving the stimulus. So once you connect them without the stimulus, you are able to recall the info also without the stimulus. Is it clear now? So memory is very easy. You have to connect the neurons in the same pattern they were connected when they were stimulated by that stimulus. I hope it's clear now. So now let me write it down. Okay. So on repeated stimulation, there is increased synaptic transmission. Okay. So on repeated stimulation, there is increase in transmission between the neurons. Okay. So on repeated stimulation, there is increase synaptic transmission between the neurons. Okay, neurons. Okay, due to increase neurotransmitters and or receptors, mainly dendrites, or increase receptor. Okay. So when you repeatedly give a stimulus, either neurotransmitters are more or the receptors are more. Okay. So either there is a increase in the neurotransmitters or receptors at the dendrites. Okay. Dendrites. Okay. Causing better and faster response in future. So that's why you get much better mechanism for this. Okay. So that's why what happens is it causes better and faster response in future. Okay, called as synaptic plasticity. I hope it's clear. So let me explain this once again. Okay, understand. When you give a stimulus, what happens? The neurotransmitters are released in the brain by the stimulus. Let's see, watch some photo, hear some sound. Is the release of neurotransmitter in the brain? But the moment stimulus disappear, like you eat something, swallow, gone. Do you remember what shirt I was wearing yesterday? Even I don't remember. Why? Because when you see the stimulus, it causes sensation in the brain. But when the stimulus is gone, the neurotransmitters stop getting released, and the ones which are previously released, they are reuptaken. So as they are reuptaken, what will be the concept? Okay. So what will be the concept? The concept is a very simple one. Okay. You will forget, but if somehow you are able to connect them very well, what will happen? Since you are able to connect them, there would be no requirement of the actual stimulus. Like example, I ask you, what was the dress you are wearing on the day of your graduation or some college fest or where you perform? You will remember it very vividly. Why? Because that stimulus is very strongly enriched in your brain because of high amount of what? Synaptic activity in that particular group of the neurons. So that is called as plasticity. And how you increase the activity? So you know, synapse is made by two things: neurotransmitter or receptor. Either increase the neurotransmitter or increase receptor, you will get increased response. So how can you get a increased response? The response can be increased by either more neurotransmitter or more receptor. That is called as what? Plasticity. So synapses are rigid or they can change. Obviously they can change. They can either become more active or less active. More active means what? You are having more release of neurotransmitter, more receptor, more ion channel opening, more function. So that is called as synaptic plasticity. Okay. Now what are the types of synaptic plasticity? So let's discuss now. Next topic is types. Types of synaptic plasticity. Okay, clear? So types of what thing? Synaptic plasticity. Okay, clear? Now let's start the discussion. Okay, clear? Fine. And I will try to explain as much as possible, because memory is something which is very interesting. Okay, and as a physiologist, I can tell you so many interesting things, so many things. Okay, so whatever you want extra, as I told you, will always be in touch. So whatever you need, you can just inform. I will be providing you the extra stuff and materials. Okay. So let's start now. Types of synaptic plasticity. Okay. So first is, I am writing the three main types, not the minor ones like the habituation, etc. First is PTP, that is post tetanic potentiation, post tetanic potentiation. Okay, so what is that post tetanic potentiation? Is this okay? So right, right. So first is on giving a train of stimulus, a train of stimuli. So you know tetanic is multiple stimulation. So on giving a train of stimuli means what? Repeated. Train means repeated, like 1 2 3 4 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. So giving a repeated train of stimuli, okay, on giving, there is increased calcium and increase neurotransmitter release. Okay, so what happens when you give the stimulus multiple time? The calcium ions which enter for exocytosis, they will accumulate. So what happens? There is the accumulation. Why? They can't leave. So accumulation due to repeated stimulation. So as the calcium is accumulated, what will be the response? Okay, so as the calcium ions are accumulating, what is the response? The response is it causes increase neurotransmitter release. Okay, clear? Now this cause increased response for few seconds. Okay, so this cause a increased response. Why? Because as the neurotransmitter remain there, you will keep getting the sensation. Okay, and you are able to remember it for some longer time. Okay, for a few seconds or maybe some minutes. Okay, so that's why it's a type of short term memory, type of short term memory called as working memory. So it will be cleared if I give an example, otherwise you will keep forgetting. Okay, so let me give an example. Imagine you are talking to someone. Okay, so as he is saying something, these words are all a part of your working memory. Why? As he is saying, the words are coming and you can feel, sense the words. Okay, now let us take an example. Okay, example is, suppose there is a young kid who want to call his grandparents, and the phone is older generation. Don't take like they have this kind of phone which only have what, the buttons. Okay, so now he doesn't remember the number. So when he goes and see the telephone directory in the other room, very heavy, he can't lift. So he open the page and see the number. What happened? When he's seeing 98231, let's say number is, so when he see, he can sense the number, but the moment he turn away, he forget the number. Yes or no? You can try. Okay, if you see a number, let's say a sequence, a code, as you see the number, you can have the sensation 9832119, but the moment you stop seeing, the sensation is there or gone, is gone na? So that is why, what is the technique to prevent the loss of the information? He start repeating the number. So what he does, he start 9811213319 9813. So he start speaking, and as he speak, he listens. As he listen, he see the same. So what's happening? The same neural pathway is triggered multiple time. So calcium builds up and cause more release of calcium. So that sequence will remain in activity for a longer time rather than just seeing and gone. So that's why sensory information finish in few seconds. But now as he keep repeating for seconds, he will remember that sequence or that number, like 983. So 931 931 931, he go to the phone, take the phone, start dialing 9832111, and then he dial and say, hello Nanaji, I am here, I am talking this. So as he is talking, what happened? That pathway will stop getting the stimulus. So neurotransmitter will be reuptaken and the receptors are not stimulated. So the information weaken and the pathway just stop firing up. And now you ask him, what was the number you dialed? Then he say, I don't remember, I forgot. I think 98 maybe 93. That is what forgetting is. I hope it's clear. Second example, let us say you are counting some currency notes, okay. So let us say you are counting 1, 2, 3, you are taking pulse of a patient 3, 4, 5, suddenly your friend comes and disturbs you, hey, what are you doing? The moment he disturbs, the train is broken and now you look at him with anger, I forgot what I was doing, at what number I was. So you can't recall the number, why? Because the chain need to keep firing. What is required? The repeated stimulation is required, repetition. You stop the repetition, stimulus is not there, the neurotransmitter is not there, you will forget what you were. So that is why mathematical calculation you are doing, 43 into 2, all require working memory and they only last for what seconds? Few. Why? Because neurotransmitters will be re-uptaken or metabolized rapidly. Is it clear now? So remember, if you give a stimulus, you feel, then the sensation feeling goes because the neurotransmitters are gone. But if you can repeat the stimulus, the information will stay for some time. So that sometime is a type of short term or working memory, okay. Now let me ask a question, can you convert this short term mechanism into a long term? The answer is what? Rather than increasing the receptor or the neurotransmitter, if you increase the receptor, the response will last for much longer time. I hope it is clear. Neurotransmitter is a short term method, receptor are a long term method. So right, the second type of plasticity, number 2, is LTP. So the second example, LTP, that is long term potentiation. So what is LTP? Long term potentiation, okay. First, long term, what is the mechanism, what? Okay, first it is by mainly CA1 neurons of hippocampus, okay. So hippocampus contains cells called as cornus ammon cells because they look like the ammon, that is what, like the you have this ship, okay. So as they are having their horns which are, you can say, angled, or they are having this snail like shape, okay. So look like the horns of a ship or like the Aries, na, Aries like that, okay. So CA1 neurons of hippocampus are the ones which are responsible. So what they do? They convert short term memory, which was because of neurotransmitter and the stimulus, they convert STM into LTM. They convert STM into LTM. STM is short term memory, into long term memory, okay. So they convert short term into long term memory. So they convert the short term into long term memory, okay. So convert the short term into long term memory, okay. How? By increase NMDA receptors at post synaptic terminal, at post synaptic terminal in neo terminals, at neo cortical neurons. Now listen to me, okay. As you increase NMDA receptors, so you know NMDA receptors are glutamate and open sodium channel. So as you know, they are glutamate and sodium channel open, and that cause EPSP, I taught that, okay. So as you increase NMDA receptor at the synapses, now what happened in that particular pathway of phone number 9831, let us say I ask you, what is your phone number? You do not have to look at the telephone directory or contacts, you can give the phone number. I said, what is your email ID? You can write the email ID. Why? Because you have seen your phone number so many times, now at those neurons in that pathway of the phone number or the email address, there is a massive increase in what substance? NMDA receptors. Once the NMDA receptor increase, what happens? The glutamate is able to act much better and cause more depolarization, more EPSP, more excitement of the neurons, resulting in next neuron firing faster and better. So what happened? The circuit I made, this circuit, this one, it will be triggered much properly and completely, causing you to recall each and every part of the information without a single mistake. So if you can replicate the same pattern by increase receptors, it causes the long term memory. Why? The answer is simple. Receptors are basically what thing, okay? Receptors are what? Proteins. Remember I told you, receptors are formed from the proteins, and proteins are formed in what? In the nucleus, then ribosome, then it is formed. So that's why once you increase the receptor protein formation, they will not be reuptaken, they will remain there for years and years. So that's why protein formation is occurring in memory formation, which make the receptors. Once receptors are inserted, those pathway, those circuits will remain highly activated for years and years. So that is why first question, okay, so that causes increase response in the neural pathway for the particular information, in the neural pathway called as long term potentiation, okay. So that is why if you increase the NMDA receptors, you get a increased response called as what? So increased response in the concerned pathway called as long term potentiation, and it causes what? It causes memory, means response for years to life. So that is why it is a type of long term memory, okay. Why? First thing is, okay, receptor formation require protein formation, okay. Second, once receptors inserted in the post synaptic terminal, they stay there for long time. So that is why you are able to have this information for much longer time, like your name, your address, you do not forget. Why? Because these circuits now have high amount of NMDA receptors. So the moment I say the word address, name, you are able to get a response just like a reflex. You do not even have to search or activate the here and there neurons, you can just give the name without any thought required, okay. So that is why this is called as long term potentiation, okay. So what is the summary? If you repeat something, there is an increased neurotransmitter in a particular pathway, let us say a phone number, a name or a face, and you can remember, recall it for few seconds, call it short term memory or working memory. But if you repeat this multiple times, what happens? There is now a change at what level? At the level of what? Protein formation. And as there is increased proteins form, increased receptor, the receptors are inserted where? In the membrane. And once you increase the receptors in the membranes will be so responsive to the stimulus, they will fire always and you are able to get the response always and always in this particular case. Is it clear? That is called as long term potentiation, okay. So what are the questions? These are the questions. What is the long term memory stored in? Synapses. Which area? Neocortex. What receptor? NMDA. What is it called as? LTP. What are the neurons? CA1. What is the area? Hippocampus. What is the result? Earlier it was neurotransmitter based memory, now it is receptor based memory. What is better? Neurotransmitter, receptor? Receptor. Why? Because the neurotransmitter will be reuptaken, metabolized, so the responsiveness will be reduced after some time. But if you increase the receptor, they are almost a permanent change you can have for life or at least for years. So that is what is called as long term memory. Is it clear? So the only method of making the memory, that is repetition. Repeat as many times, but there are some shortcuts also. If I get time, I can explain, but right now I will focus mainly on what concept? On the concepts of memory formation by synaptic plasticity. Third method is LTD. LTD. What is LTD? Long term depression, okay. It involves basically GABA receptors, So remember, long term stimulation require the glutamate, it require basically GABA receptors, okay, and it is mainly seen in cerebellum for motor skills and motor memory. Okay, example: driving, typing, etc. Okay, so where is that depression system working? Cerebellum, and it help in having the motor memory. Like example, you can type without seeing and without thinking. A juggler can juggle without thinking. Why? Because once you have a synaptic pathway created, you don't have to search. You just give the command, output come just like a reflex. Give a stimulus, response is there. Give a trigger, the information is out. That is why memory can be formed. Now you will say, sir, but it is depression. I'm telling you one thing, if possible to understand. If I want to make an info, if there is a white page, what I can do? I can make a person by drawing it. That is, I increase or add info. This is like potentiation of the already existing neuron by making some neurons more activated. So that's why out of all possible, I make some highly activated. But I can do the reverse also. Like take a block of stone and remove unwanted pieces. Again, you make a statue, but this time you added the information or you removed unwanted information. So that is something it does. Rather than adding the info or making something stronger, it removes the weak unwanted. So that is why as you keep doing the thing, the errors, the what wrong circuits are eliminated, only the right pathways, right circuits are there. Like when you learn to drive, initially you have to search for the gearbox, but once you know driving, you don't have to search for the gearbox or the clutch. Exactly your hand goes and you will grab the clutch at exact moment, exact location. So where is this information stored? Cerebellum store this information called as what? Long term memory for motor skills via long term depression.